I am Peter Guilford, and with John Wiles, together we will be speaking to Giovanni Seppia, who has an international reputation as one of the foremost experts on internet governance worldwide. He will be speaking to us about the future of the internet. Okay, so let's crack on with the first question. Giovanni, you've been operating in the world of internet governance in Europe for over 20 years. What have been the most significant changes that you can think of?
Thank you. I see two main changes. The first one at communication level, I see the shift from domain names and websites to a greater dependence on social media platforms. And the second at governance level, and in the governance sector, I see the transition to a truly multi-stakeholder model and also an increase at regulatory level at worldwide and also European Union in the European Union environment. And that reflects probably the desire of the public to have governments more involved into the internet governance to protect their interest.
Giovanni, the EU's proposals for a revised framework for regulating big tech and their platforms have been much criticized. Do you have reservations about them?
Europe must avoid planting thickets of regulation that stifle the green leaves of change and innovation. I believe that Europe must become the new cradle of innovation. That is what probably is currently missing. Too many rules that generally take too long to adopt impose costs on European Union operators. And this is something that is overlooked by regulators. And as a matter of fact, there are quite many SMEs that are literally driven in the arms of large overseas companies because they cannot afford the cost and burdens of the new regulations.
So if I can just follow up, do you think that there is a risk that the EU's attempts to make the internet a fairer and safer place might prevent Europe from matching or surpassing the startup culture of the US West Coast?
I believe that the efforts that are currently placed in the regulatory, environment to introduce new rules are efforts that should be counterbalanced by efforts to facilitate the life of SMEs and especially SMEs operating in the innovation sector.
Giovanni, some people think that the internet is resistant to change. And indeed that younger people should be more involved in running the internet because some kind of generational change is needed. Do you think this is right?
Well, young people are the key to the future of the internet. What we see is that most of the cases they prefer to use the internet tools rather than participating in the governance of the internet and of its tools. That is the sort of generational nut that we have to crack in the future. And that is why at EURid we have established a EURid Youth Committee that is providing us with advice on multiple matters, from marketing to policies and procedures, from international engagement to partnership. The current internet managers have a duty to educate the next generation on how to share their ideas, vision, and creativity. That is of paramount importance if we want to look forward and build the next generation internet.
So do you believe this could lead to some kind of new golden age for the domain name business?
I believe that the domain name business, our industry needs fresh ideas to be more competitive against those social media platforms that in the past decade they have taken over and they have been preferred by companies and individuals. And if you start working with the next generation, you will see that they always come up with fresh ideas how to make what is your standard business more innovative. And this is, again, something that we have appreciated a lot when we started working with our youth committee.
Giovanni, let's talk a little about EURid. What is its role and why do we hear so little about it? It's in the business of internet governance, but is internet governance a suitable vehicle for promoting European values like carbon neutrality, gender equality, or even multilingualism?
Thank you. EURid is the registry manager of the .eu top level domain appointed by the European Commission. We belong to a registry community whose members do not have enough time and resources to jump into high-level political debates. We are a real technical community. Our first priority is to serve and protect the users of the .eu top-level domain. So we are working hard mainly behind the scenes to guarantee the users of the .eu top-level domain a safe environment with the minimal risk of security breaches and disruptions. At the same time, we are proud citizens of Europe, and our perspectives are somehow global. And that's why we uphold European values. So we work hard to promote multilingualism, carbon neutrality, and a sustainable internet. And that shows that we live European values on a daily basis.
Giovanni, it seems that we're already fighting an endless war against cyber attacks. Is there a frontline role for EURid in the fight against cybercrime, and how effective can you be?
So cyber attacks have indeed become part of our life, especially if you are a technical operator of the domain name industry. At EURid, we have set up a robust and well-backed up technical infrastructure. And we are regularly working together with different companies and agencies to make sure that our domain namespace functions effectively. And also, at the same time, we upgrade our security infrastructure. So we are doing quite a lot to prevent and fight cyber attacks. And this is, again, part of registry life.
Giovanni, some people think that the internet is heading for division and fragmentation because China and Russia want to be even stronger global powers. Some also think it is run by the US. What is the reality for you?
It's a very interesting question, and I participated in a process to transition the US oversight to the internet community. So first of all, at present, the internet is fully managed by all of us, by the internet community. The US government oversight is something that belongs to history. At the same time, fragmentation is very unlikely because the internet works on a global, vast technical infrastructure. So whoever starts a parallel internet would need to convince all the internet users to start working and moving to the parallel technical infrastructure, which is something that is, again, very unlikely to happen. The challenge of building any new system is enormous. And even if successful, it could easily be a white elephant shunned by global communities.
Giovanni, EURid has something around 3.7 million users. Do you see plenty of growth potential still in the this domain name? And what sort of numbers would you hope for, say, in 5 years' time?
It's a very good question, because if you think about the growth of the domain name industry at present against the growth of 10 years ago, is we moved from a two-digit or to a one-digit growth or a negative growth. At the same time, we see a quality growth. So I'm looking at a growth that is a healthy growth, which means that domain names that are registered are going to be domain names that are used for emails or for websites. And that is what I believe is more important for any registry.
Giovanni, thank you very much for a very interesting session. I think I and others will be impressed by your insistence on the need for generational change in the management, the governance of the internet. And I'm also struck by the efforts you at EURid are actually making to dialogue with a younger generation on some of the key issues of the internet. So again, thank you for your time, and until the next time.
Pleasure.